subscribe to Bizbo and press the bell icon. See boring news turn into enjoyable stories. There are many versions to the Mehul Choksi story. Version 1 is what Choksi is telling. Version 2 is what Choksi is not telling. Version 3 is the Indian government's version. And version 4 is the likely version. Let's start with version 1, what Choksi is telling. Darling, I'm going for dinner with a friend. He drove from his home into the posh Jolly Harbour neighborhood in the Caribbean islands of Antigua and Barbuda, a part of the West Indies, to the home of his friend Barbara Jarabik, a former British model who knew him as
Raj. Come in, I'll join you in just a minute.
As he settled himself comfortably on the sofa, suddenly 8 to 10 muscular men barged in. Who are you? What do you want? Barbara, help! Shut up, man. We are with the Antiguan police. But instead of arresting him, they began beating him up, taking away his wallet, Rolex watch and mobile phone. Then used a taser gun to give him an electric shock and gagged him, put him in handcuffs, bundled his half-conscious self onto a wheelchair and took him through the backside of Jarabik's residence, which was right next to the jetty, onto a small watercraft to be whisked away. Then in the high seas, transferring him onto a bigger vessel, where waiting for him were 2 Indians and 3 men of Caribbean descent. Do as we say and you won't get hurt. While being held captive at sea, Choksi was told, some special guest from Delhi wants to talk to you. But no call came and he was instead dumped on a beach in the Commonwealth of Dominica, an island country about 100 nautical miles south of Antigua and Barbuda. Locals found a badly beaten and bruised person lying on the beach. Who are you? What happened to you?
My name is Mehul Choksi, a citizen of Antigua, and I have been kidnapped.
This is what he wrote in a 5-page letter to Antiguan authorities while in custody of the Dominican police. Now let's see the version that Choksi is not telling. But before we move ahead, please take a few seconds to hit the like button and subscribe to Bizbo. It's no secret that Choksi acquired the citizenship of Antigua and Barbuda to escape the clutches of the law, as he, along with his nephew and co-accused Nirav Modi, had defrauded Punjab National Bank of 11,500 crore, about $1.5 billion, which incidentally is about equal to the GDP of this tourism-reliant island where Choksi took refuge. Since then, he has used every trick in the book to stay away from Indian courts. I'm unwell. I'm innocent. I'm not even an Indian citizen. Making friends in the Caribbean island, especially with a neighbor who happened to come live opposite him in 2020, and with whom it seems he was immediately smitten. Hi, welcome to the neighborhood. I'm Raj.
Hello, I'm Barbara.
Raj was a perfect gentleman, gifting her diamond rings and bracelets.
Wow, for me, you're a darling, Raj.
They were good friends for over 9 months and even attended some events together. But allegedly, Raj soon became obsessed with her, sending her hundreds of texts and messages every day from multiple numbers. Then on a hunch,
I need to know the value of these precious stones.
I'm sorry to say, ma'am, but you have been cheated. These are just pieces of glass. Whether it was the fake diamonds or Raj's obsession, Barbara claims to have broken off the friendship and even moved away from the Choksis. Now let's see version 3. What Indian authorities claim to have happened. Because Antigua has an extradition treaty with India, it was felt that the chances of getting Choksi back were good. Earlier in 2021, Antiguan Prime Minister Gaston Brown even publicly stated, Choksi would be sent back to India after he exhausts all his appeals. So in May, a small team of Indian officials led by CBI's Deputy Inspector General Sharda Raut visited the island nation to finalize formalities related to Choksi's deportation. It was decided that he would be put on a flight back to India, just like in the case of Abu Salim and Monica Bedi, where a police team in Portugal brought them back via a commercial flight. It seemed to be only a matter of a few months before he would be deported. But then, he disappeared. 2 days later, a local reporter doing the rounds of police stations in Dominica heard an interesting story.
We found a passportless Indian on the beach, someone named Mehul Choksi. He claims he was kidnapped. We have taken him into custody.
Flummoxed Indian authorities hastily made their way to the Caribbean island, hoping to take him to India directly from there. Even hiring a charter jet from the Qataris, costing 3 crores for a round trip, a hefty price for the taxpayer, but worth it if the effort paid off. In Dominica, Choksi was charged with illegal entry, but being a citizen of Antigua, his likely port of deportation would not be India. But Indian authorities thought they could exploit a flaw in his case. As in May, the Antiguan government had begun a process of revoking his citizenship because Choksi did not inform them about Interpol's red corner notice issued against him while filing his citizenship application. Mehul had also not followed due procedure while renouncing his Indian citizenship in 2018, so there was a chance the Dominican court would agree. But the High Court of Dominica disappointed the Indian team.
Mehul Choksi is given interim bail to travel back to Antigua for medical treatment.
Now let's speculate on what is likely to have happened. According to Indian authorities, while Choksi was in Antigua, he obviously must have realized that the extradition net was closing in on him. "I must do something, otherwise I'll be deported to India." So he allegedly decided to flee from Antigua and Barbuda to Cuba, a country that has no extradition agreement with India. A safe haven made famous in Kabir Khan's Ekta Tiger song, Lapata. But he needed a transporter who could get him out of the country undetected. So he could have created a ruse and weaved a story of kidnapping. However, Choksi's habit of scamming everyone he met didn't work with the people he hired to help him flee Antigua.
"Mr. Choksi, the money you promised to wire us hasn't reached us yet. It's a weekend, you will get it first thing on Monday morning."
But they were not convinced.
"Should we believe him about the money? He didn't even pay us the promised half before the operation."
So they cut their losses and dumped him on the nearest beach. However, Dominica is on the opposite direction to Cuba. So either he was layering his trip to put authorities off track, or there was some miscommunication and Choksi actually intended to go to the Dominican Republic, which is also another island in the Caribbean and on the way to Cuba. His wife Preeti, unaware of the turn of events, proceeded according to plan.
"Inspector, my husband is missing. He hasn't come back for 2 days. He has been kidnapped."
Based on her complaint, Antiguan police issued a yellow notice, a global police alert for a missing person. Planned to flee to Cuba in tatters, Choksi thought on his feet.
"Maybe I can say I was kidnapped and tortured and make it look like an Indian operation."
Hoping to at least use these allegations to open yet another case whose investigations would delay his deportation further, and therefore agreed to meet the reporter.
"And that's how I landed here in jail."
Soon, the news spread like wildfire and reached Choksi's family members and legal team. Choksi's lawyer seemed to even know the name of the alleged abductors.
"Gurjeet Singh Bhandal and Gurmeet Singh are mercenaries who Indian officials hired to illegally deport Mr. Choksi from Antigua."
But which abductor leaves his calling card with the victim?
"These are my contact details. Call me if you ever need my services."
His wife Preeti too thought on her feet, attempting to turn it into a human rights issue.
"I am going to write a letter to the Queen to bring her attention to Mehul's suffering."
Smartly turning around Mehul's weakest link, Barbara, into a special agent, claiming that the Hungarian passport holder model,
"This woman laid a honey trap to bring him back to India."
A claim quickly dismissed by Indian intelligence officials, as they will be questioned by the court on the legality of his extradition.
"How did you bring him here? Due process was followed, Your Honor."
As also by Barbara, who denied any involvement.
"If I was an agent, I'd had many other opportunities. Why would I do that in Jolly Harbour?"
The Jolly Harbour neighbourhood in question is a resort village on the west coast of the Caribbean island. It is also home to the Prime Minister of Antigua and has a slew of security checkposts, making his abduction story unlikely, unless of course everyone was in on it. Further, the police also found that while Choksi's wife and lawyers claimed he left home at 5 p.m. local time on Sunday, May 23rd, Dominican officials claimed that Choksi was found at 10 p.m. local time on the same day, 5 hours later. But it takes at least 12 to 13 hours to cover the 188-kilometer distance between the two islands by sea. Unless, of course, the bigger boat he was switched to was powerful enough to bridge the time gap. While the captain and the boat's owner both deny transporting Choksi, both them and the two British Indians, Gurjeet Singh Bhandal and Gurmeet Singh, accused of kidnapping Choksi, sailed for Dominica on the morning of May 23rd. Too much of a coincidence?
We came to Antigua on May 23rd and sailed the same day to reach Dominica at night.
Why would someone come to Antigua from Britain in the morning and immediately sail the very same morning for Dominica? Wouldn't they go straight to Dominica instead? Principal Inspector of Antiguan Customs Randy Baltimore, in a handwritten note on email, contradicts them.
Both passengers arrived on 15th April 2021.
A fourth accused, Gurdeep, aka Dev Bhatt, a resident of Tony Mayfair in London and who holds a diplomatic passport issued by St. Kitts and Nevis, another Caribbean island, and who has a tendency to display photographs of himself with famous personalities, including one with Prime Minister Modi, apparently travelled to and from Antigua around the same time as Barbara, Bhandal and Singh. The latter three, who allegedly left Antigua for London on the same British Airways flight on May 28th. Mehul's wife Preeti's claims about Barbara not knowing who Raj really was seem to be logical.
Everybody on the island knew who Choksi was.
Barbara is supposed to be a businesswoman. Surely she would have checked.
So was Mehul using Barbara as a pawn, or was it the other way around? However, Tariq Ghaffour, a former Assistant Commissioner of London's Metropolitan Police Service,
all four accused have been completely exonerated after investigations.
Meanwhile, Choksi's brother Chetan had allegedly promised Lennox Linton, Dominica's opposition leader,
"Please support my brother's case. We will help get your party a huge donation."
India is also playing the vaccine diplomacy card and recently offered Antigua 40,000 doses for its citizens. However, both Antigua and Dominica, which follow UK's judicial system, have a bad reputation of harbouring white-collar criminals. Now, if only Vivian Richards, Antigua and Barbuda's most famous son, were to become Prime Minister, we'd get Mehul Choksi back in a jiffy. Bizbo's limerick. Mehul Choksi's case has taken new twists and turns. One after another, a new story is churned. So was he abducted or another fraud concocted? It surely will delay extradition, and that's the concern. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.